No, let me complete.
Ram Chandrappa, one minute, you've made your point.
Between
Ram Chandrappa, when I add 55 and 28, it is coming to 83%. So 83% are either saying repeal or amend the laws. The government is saying we are open to negotiations, but when you push through a law, it appears that you've done it in a manner without contemplating the level of backlash.
Absolutely.
Does that is that a sense that you get from this poll?
Well, I think the government should listen to this poll, because in some senses they scored a self-goal by ramming through an ordinance and then saying, look, we are willing to amend and repeal and do all those things. They haven't shown themselves in good light, including in the recent thing that we will defer it for 1.5 years. Then what was the hurry to rush through in a pandemic? These laws, by the way, I believe are good. The farm sector does require reform.
No, but it's also the consultative process.
Correct.
And how you bring
the
law.
Also, see, the laws per se will not change the way you do business. You take a look at the Green Revolution. Why was it such a success in Punjab? The same farmers are now protesting. The government laid the infrastructure down before they did it. Now you take the infrastructure they did. Hybrid seeds they brought in. Water was ready, available over there. Then fertilizers were brought in from wherever. Then what they did most importantly was education. They had the best communication system. So when they handheld the farmers and took them through the Green Revolution, it wasn't that the farmer was not protesting. Now take a look at the way they've done this. Right? They might say that, oh, we had a consultative process. Mm-hmm. It went on for 10, 15 years. But when they were implementing a major law like this, which is going to change the playing field completely, they should have taken the farmers in, their own cabinet. I mean, let's not forget that Harsimrat Kaur Badal, who represents the SAD, walked out on the cabinet protesting that they were not consulted. So
but what this shows, Sanju Varman, that's
good.
The point that the government needs to ponder over in the manner in which these bills were rushed through, first as an ordinance and then turned into law. People seem to believe that there was inadequate consultation, which is why 83% of the respondents want the bills to be amended or repealed. Once again, I'm coming to you, Chengal Reddy. Let Sanju Varma respond to the feedback on how the bill was pushed through. We'll come to you.
Sanju Varma. Let her respond and we'll come to the both of you. Let her respond very quickly. Sanju Varma, keep it short. Respond.
Sir, why are you allowing... Sir, please harass farmers.
Yes.
It is not the
okay,
Rajdeep. People that... No, no, it is not...
Rajdeep and Rahul, let me just tell you one thing very categorically. You know, this... You know, why is somebody interrupting me?
Come on, quickly.
Why is somebody interrupting me? Please, sir, you'll have your chance. You know, quickly, the simple point is this. There was an ordinance that came into effect with respect to the farm bills on the 5th of June 2020. Post 5th of June... Both these, all the three farm bills were duly passed in the parliament on the 27th of September 2020, post which they became laws. So, A, these farm laws are absolutely constitutional, and if anybody doubts their bona fide, you are basically raising a question on the entire parliamentary process.
No, but it never went through the parliamentary process in the way that it should have. It was brought as an ordinance and Chengal Reddy. I think the point... No, once again, if we are tone deaf to data, once again, if we are tone deaf to data, then there's no conversation you can have.
Let Chengal Reddy respond.
This data is telling you that people aren't satisfied with the way the laws were pushed through, that there is inadequate consultation because they want either the law to be amended or repealed. They won't say so otherwise.
No. Please, yes. Mr. Rajdeep, let me tell you this. Yes. It is utter absurdity and nonsense if you say there is no consultation. Please, for the last 30 years, there are humpty number of reports, Swaminathan, Sarat Joshi, Parliament Committee. We farmers, we have been demanding removal of Essential Commodities Act, liberalizing the Contract Act, and APMC. What the heck is mean to say that there is no consultation and all?